This vehicle alone can determine the outcome of a battle. It is as useful as it is dangerous for the team that spawned it. Let me explain what I mean by that. First of all, here's how it works. The attackers can only spawn it from the first objective in their line and the defenders from the objective zero. Once you spawn it as an attacker, all the teammates in the same line as you will be able to deploy in it, and if you are a defender, then everyone in your team can. Yes, the APC will be visible for them to spawn in it for the whole duration of the battle, even if you get out of it, unless something of the following happens. It will disappear from the spawn screen for 15 seconds if a component gets damaged or destroyed, if the driver or a passenger inside dies, if it gets spotted, if an enemy is within 30 meters from its location and he can see it directly, and it will disappear forever if it gets unlocked or destroyed. The goal of the driver is to get this vehicle as close to the next objective as possible, and in some situations even behind the objectives if getting across is too difficult for the majority of the team. Some drivers may even decide to get the APC across at the start of the game when the enemy team less expects it, and he will use forts like this to remain undetected. They also carry grenades, so they can easily destroy mines hidden in the water. Or they will ask a teammate to destroy them with a plane using bombs or high explosive ammo, or a friendly tanker with high explosive shells. The problem with this is that we as humans prefer the path of least resistance, which means that we prefer to spawn behind the enemy to get some easy kills and hunt for recons, but we all get that idea at the same time, which leaves no one behind to defend, and thus the enemy team wins the game while we still look for snipers in church. Some drivers, to discourage this behavior, they will drive the APC far away and only bring it back when the time is right. So, what makes a good driver? Basically, if you are a shepherd, you are qualified. You need to lead your ship to the objective without being seen by the wolves. The closer you get the APC to the enemy objective without being seen, the more likely are your teammates to actually get in the objective to capture it instead of wandering around. A rule of thumb for beginners is to hide the APC at the spawn location that you will unlock after capturing the next objective. But be careful, because if you lose the previous objective, this spawn will now open for the enemy team, catching you with your pants down once they spawn. Another idea is to place the APC at the line that is formed between the objective you have and the one you want. This will encourage the team to go attack while also defending the one you already have. Be careful when placing the APC to the flanks, since this can either leave your objective vulnerable to attacks, or you might be standing in the line of attack of the enemy team. Also, a good idea is to keep the APC moving. That's because if you leave the APC in one spot, the enemy team will eventually figure out that something is going on, because they will either see a large group of people constantly attacking from the same weird direction, or someone will kill the same person twice really fast. So moving the APC will constantly change the direction that your team is following to get to the objective, and thus confuse the enemy and make you less vulnerable to these weapons. And you will make some nice FXP. But it's true that a moving target is easier to spot, so prefer doing this in objectives that have a lot of trees and bushes to hide you. Finally, as we said, getting the APC behind the enemy lines is very risky, but also very rewarding. It should be done when your team can't advance, or when you are desperate and running out of time. Just make sure that you have one friend to help you with the mines so you can get across fast, and one more to defend the previous objective to reduce the risks. If you are a defender, use the APCs as a backup plan. Place it close to the zero objectives, because often the enemy team might catch yours off guard and capture one of them before your team even has time to realize it. So you need something close, so your team can quickly recapture it before too many enemies spawn there to defend it. For the same reasons, if you are defending just one line, place it to the spawn point of your first objective. As you may have realized, all of these require you to know the maps and the spawns. Here are some examples to get you up to speed if you are new to the game. But don't worry, just pay attention to them when you play and you will learn them soon enough. As for skirmishes, each team has only one spawn location and there are three objectives. Try to hide at least two APCs and always keep an eye out to defend them, because these maps are small and the enemies can find them easily. As for the two encounter maps, your options are limited. Just get it as close as possible. is the armored version really worth your money and time to unlock? First of all, the regular can be equipped with two supply boxes and the armored with just one. The armored versions have machine guns to defend yourself in case an enemy is chasing you with a vehicle, but they make a lot of noise and smoke. Many times, new players might use them to shoot at tanks or planes for some reason, thus blowing up your cover and getting you killed. So if that happens, either press 4 to lock the weapon from your teammates, and if you are a leader, kick the squad member from the squad if he doesn't read the chat. By the way, if you get kicked instead, you can't lock the gun anymore. Neither of them can survive a mine. The armored versions offer greater protection from regular bullets, which means your modules or base structure are less likely to get damaged and thus disappear from the map for 15 seconds. And also they come with protective shields on the windows that you can activate if you press the crouch button. But here's the deal, you are not supposed to be seen or shot at. Also, you only have two wheels, which if they get destroyed, you will be going terribly slow, meanwhile the regular has six. And the tracks you have are only useful on the Kotor map where there is mud. Both of them have similar top speeds when driving off-road, but the regular versions have a lot better acceleration. And on the road, the regular track is better in any way, with touches these things uphill, downhill, off-road, anything you can imagine. The regular track always won, with one exception. Because the armored track is heavier, it can push obstacles out of the way easier. And finally, one of the biggest reasons the regular APC is better, it's because it's harder to destroy with explosives. You can't hit the cloth in the back, and you won't deal damage to the vehicle if you hit the carriage. It will only deal damage if the explosive comes in an angle that will travel through and hit the base structure. The armor takes damage no matter what. And yes, both of them can survive one hit straight to the engine. By the way, the US track is impossible to flip with. So yeah, the money you would spend for the armored version, use them for a camo instead. Here are the ones that I would recommend. Lastly, a really important thing to remember is that in the war mode, these vehicles are really scarce because most people know how important they are, and they keep queuing for them, thus making the time you need to get some really long. So try to conserve as many of them as you can. And that's it, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. The armored versions offer greater protection. The armored versions offer greater protection from regular bullets, which means your modules or base structure are less likely to get A rule of thumb for beginners is to hide the APC at the spawn location that you will unlock if